Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let's take a look at 10 useful things that you could do with the Clips app on your iPhone. MacMost is supported by more than 600 viewers just like you. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So the Clips app is a free app you can get from Apple for your iPhone. It's a lot of fun to play with, but it's also pretty useful. So here's just a sampling of ideas that you can do with the Clips app. So first, when you go into the Clips app, kind of by default, you're here in the camera and you can record yourself talking with the actual real background behind you. But you could switch over to Scenes, and Scenes allows you to talk with a fake background behind you. Now this could be useful sometimes because you can record yourself talking without worrying about the background. I'm going to select this background here and now I can record myself talking and record a message for somebody. Sometimes text just doesn't do it and you want to record a message for somebody or for a group of people. And it could be something serious for business use, or it could just be something for fun where you thought that a little personal video of you talking was nice. So now you've got that video there and you can use the share button to send it. The share button, of course, we're going to use at the end of all of these because that's the whole idea. You create something and then you share it. So I've recorded myself talking without worrying about what was behind me. I can hit the share button and now I can share it as a message, as an email. I can upload it to various sites, Instagram, Facebook, all that kind of thing. Okay, so my second idea is not video at all. It's the opposite. It's just plain text. Let's say you want to post something to social media, like a quote or just a brief message, but you don't want it to appear as just plain text where it can easily get lost as people scroll through all their stuff. Well, you can go to Posters and then you can choose from any one of these backgrounds. There's tons of them and you can scroll through them and select something that's appropriate. Select whatever the background is that you want and then there's text there in the middle. I can select the text and type, you know, whatever I want. And when I'm done, I have this text on the background. I can now go and share it. You probably see stuff that looks like this a lot on Facebook and Instagram and such. And it's so easy to create them in Clips. Now, likewise, you can use text on a picture you already have. Matter of fact, sometimes it's great to caption a picture before posting it. So I can go to my library here and then choose a photo from my photos library. So I can choose it like that. I can move it around and recrop it if I wanted to. And then touch the star. And that gives me a bunch of different things I can do to it. I can select text and then select from different types of text. I'll just choose something like that. Type something in. Tap when I'm done and I can even shrink, enlarge, and make the text appear on an angle if I want. Hit the X button and now I have a captioned photo that I could share. Now you could also do things with video. You could go back to your library and I can select a video here. Now in order to share this video, I need to re-record it. I tap that big button underneath there and I hold it down. And while I'm holding it down, the video will play, but I could also talk and it will capture my voice in the microphone and blend that with the audio from the video. So I can caption what's going on in the video. So I'll tap and hold and now as I'm talking, it's actually recording my voice. I can even move the video, zooming in, moving around, talking about different things I see in the video. And then when I release, what I get at the bottom, you can see there, if I tap that, that's actually the video with me talking. Hold. And now as I'm talking, it's actually recording my voice. So now it's like a narrated video and I can go and share that out instead of the original video, which may not make as much sense unless people read whatever I type with it. And a lot of times people don't read. So it's nice to be able to narrate things. Now you can also do the same with an image. So you can narrate an image. How do you do that? Well, you select an image. And then you start recording and it will record your voice, but you could zoom in on different parts of the image, move around as you talk to talk about different things that you see in the image, and it will record all those movements as well as your voice. And now I could go and play that back.
It will record your voice, but you could zoom in on different parts of the image, move around.
Now you can also use this to create a slideshow, and I've talked about this before. So I could take this first image and I can record it for a little bit. Now it'll record my voice as well, but if you keep quiet, instead of just recording the noise in the room, it won't record anything. It's listening for your voice, and if it doesn't hear it, it'll just keep it silent. So let me record a few seconds of this. Now I can go back to my library, select another photo, and record a few seconds of that. Do the same thing, photo after photo. and I can create my slideshow. If I tap down here below, I could even see all the different pictures, and I can tap and rearrange them, move them around to change the order. And then when I go and share them, it's going to share a video of all of those from the slideshow. Now, kind of going back to those poster ideas, let's say instead of text you want to share an emoji. Now, it's pretty typical to respond with a text message or something online with an emoji, but the character size is always going to be about the same depending upon the platform you're using. Sometimes it will be nice to actually make the emoji really big or combine it with other emojis. But you can use the same concept that I showed before with just text on a background. I can go to posters here. I could find something like maybe one of these solid color backgrounds at the top. And I could select the text and just delete that. Now I can go and tap the star, and you could see I can add text there as well. But I could also add stickers, which are kind of like emoji or emoji itself. So I can choose from all of these. So I can choose something that I like there. I can pinch out to zoom in. I can even rotate it a little bit like that. I can combine it with other pieces of emoji at the same time, just add as much as I want there. And then I could go and share this so the person gets a really large emoji, maybe even on a nicer background, instead of just the regular character emoji. Now let's go back to the idea of videos. You could use the Clips app to actually trim and merge videos. So let's go back to library here, and I've got a video here. Now in order to include this, I need to record it for a little bit. So I'll be quiet so I don't add any additional audio to it. Now it's a 22 second video, but I only added a few seconds of it. What I'm going to do now is go into that by tapping on it, and you can see there's a trim tool there. I can hit the trim tool and it'll show me the portion I selected. I can actually move the right side of that and include the entire thing. So I didn't have to record for 22 seconds to get all the video. Just 3 seconds was all I needed, and now I can stretch this all the way out. But I could also grab the other end and get exactly the portion I want and hit trim, and now I've got that section in there. I actually find it easier sometimes to use split, and then you can position this where you want. This works really well, especially if there's somebody talking in the video. You can find the spot where you want to cut it. Then you hit split, and now it's two portions here, and I could select either portion and then hit delete to get rid of that. I can also merge clips by simply hitting done, and then going to the library again, grabbing another clip, recording that for a few seconds, and now I've got both clips in there. So I basically merged the two of them. And I could go into that second clip and I could trim to select a different area of that, or use split as well. I could drag these around to change the order. So I could add a whole bunch of different clips in there and they're merged together. The only problem with this, of course, is Clips does everything square. So you're going to get square output from this. But if you don't mind that, it's a really quick way to merge videos together. Now Clips is also a great way to quickly filter video. There's a bunch of filters in here. Let's go into the library first and select a video that I want to use. Then before I record it, I want to hit the star and select filters. Now there are various different types of filters, and you can see kind of a preview at the top of what you get. There's even some video stuff like camcorder, aged film, that kind of thing. So pick something that you like. Like let's pick this one right here, and then I'll exit that, and now I can record that video. Again, a few seconds is all I need because I can tap on it, then go to trim and extend the amount. And now when I play it back, the entire video is filtered. It's kind of like applying a photo filter, but all the way across all the frames of the video. So now when I share this, it's got that filtered effect. So I've saved the best idea for last, and this is to use Clips to easily create a video journal or diary. And this could be something that you just save for yourself, but it also could be something that you share. So to do this, you just have the camera on like this, or you could use scenes and have, you know, one of these funky backgrounds if you want to do that. Either way, you can record a bit and stop. So I can talk a little bit about my day right here and stop. Then I can record a little bit more and talk a bit more about my day and stop. Each time I'm just pressing down and releasing. So I can talk about different things going on, create a story in bits and pieces. If I ever want to go back and delete something, I can. I could just tap there in it, select any one of these, and hit delete. I can also, of course, trim and split as well, and I could rearrange if I need. Now I don't just have to do my own video, because if I took a picture during that day, I can go into the library, I can select a picture, and then I could talk over that picture. Like here's a picture I like. So now I've got myself talking. I go to a picture. Now I can go back to myself talking and do a little bit more like that. And when I'm done, the entire thing could be shared easily as a video. I can hit the share button. And naturally, if I'm going to share it to YouTube, Instagram, Facebook, I've got those buttons right there. But I could also use save video, and that will save it out to my photo library. If I don't want to do that, I can use save to files. And save to files will export this as a video file, and I could save it to iCloud Drive. So I can have a folder there of video diaries. I can record these every day. It'll be great to do while undergoing a new experience or traveling. You can record a little diary at the end of each day, show some photos. You can post it for everybody, but you could also just save it as your own video diary to remember the experience by. So those are just kind of like 10 random ideas I came up with by playing around with the Clips app. There's so much more that you can do with it as well, and I'm sure you can come up with some great ideas of how to use all those features to quickly make little videos and photos that you could share or keep. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.